Let us take some technical aptitude question in RDBMS. So this will be very helpful in your Viva or interview questions. What is database? The first question always will be, what is database? So a database is logically coherent collection of data with some inherent meaning and representing some aspect of real world, and which is designed, built and populated with data for a specific purpose. There are various definitions of database. This is just one of them. So database is a set of interrelated data or organized data. These are all databases definition. What is a DBMS, database management system? It's a collection of program. You know, you have a database, now you apply some, or you have some certain programs with it. So if you have a collection of programs that enable user to create and maintain a database, this is DBMS. So in other words, it is a general purpose software that provides the user with the process of defining, constructing, manipulating the database for various applications. What is DBMS, database management system, we have seen? What is DB, database, we have seen? Now the question is, what is database system? What is database system now? So database system, the database and this DBMS software, they are together called as a database system. Advantages of DBMS. What is the advantages of DBMS? In this, all the advantages of DBMS, which it has over the file-based systems, you can mention all those, like redundancy is controlled, authorized access is restricted, authorized access is only allowed. It provides multiple user interfaces. It enforces the integrity constraints. It provides backup and recovery. What are the disadvantages in file processing system? Data redundancy and inconsistency. Data redundancy and inconsistency was there in file processing system. It was very difficult to access the data. Data was not isolated. There is no data isolation. The integrity was a problem. You cannot concurrently access the data. That is, concurrent access is not possible. And of course, it was not secure, not protected. So security issues was always there. Describe the three levels of data abstraction. So there are three levels of data abstraction. First is your physical level, then logical level, then you have view level. Physical level is the lowest level of abstraction, this which describes how data is stored. That is the physical level. Then in logical level, the next higher level of abstraction, it describes what data are stored in database and what relationship among those data is. How data is stored, what data are stored in the database, and what relationship among those data. Then view level means the highest level of abstraction. It describes only part of the entire database, that is the instance. You know, it can only give a view at that particular instance. So physical level is how data is stored, then logical level is what data is stored, and then above it we have view level, which gives a glimpse or a view of the data database. Define the integrity rules. So the integrity rules, there are two integrity rules. First is your entity integrity, then you have referential integrity. Entity integrity and referential integrity. So this entity integrity states that primary key cannot have a null value. Primary key can never be equal to null. Okay, this is your first integrity rule, that is the entity integrity. Then you have referential integrity. What is referential integrity? It states that the foreign key can either a null value or should be a primary key value of another relationship. Okay, foreign key can either be a null value or should be a primary key of the other relationship. We'll be talking about this primary and foreign shortly. What is extension and intention? What do we mean when you say extension and intention? The answer here is, extension means it is the number of tuples present in a table at any instance. So this is time dependent, extension. Number of tuples present in a table at any instance. While intention, it is a constant value that gives the name, structure of the table and the constraints laid on it. So this remains constant. Okay. That is why it is intention. Extension can vary because tuples can vary, and depending upon the time it will vary. So this is extension, the other is intention. What is system R? What are its two major subsystems? What is system R? Okay, this one. What are its two major subsystems? System R was designed and developed over a period of 74 to 79 at IBM. It is a prototype and its purpose was to demonstrate that it is possible to build a relationship, a relation system that can be used in a real life environment to solve real life problem with performance at least comparable to that of existing system. So there are two subsystems. The two subsystems in system R is your resource storage and your system relational data system. That is the resource system storage and system relation data system. This is system R. How is the data structure of system R different from the relational structure? How is the data structure of system R is different from the relational structure? So unlike relation systems in system R, domains are not supported. First of all, enforcement of candidate key uniqueness is optional. Enforcement of entity integrity is optional, and differential integrity is not enforced. So this is the difference of system R with the relational structure. What is data independence? When the data are independent, they are data independence. Is it so? I will see the answer. Data independence means the application is independent. The application is independent of the storage structure and the access strategy of data. Data independence here means that the application is independent of the storage structure and access strategy of data. So in other terms, the ability to modify the schema definition in one level should not affect the schema definition at the next higher level. That is why these two levels, the data are independent. Okay, the application is independent of any data storage structure and access strategy of data. So there are two types of data independence. First is your physical data independence, then you have logical data independence. What is physical data independence? Modification in physical level should not affect the logical level, of course. And logical data independence is just like physical data independence. It says that the modification in logical level should not affect the view level. So logical data independence is more difficult to achieve. What is a view? What is a view and how it is related to the data independence? What is a view and how it is related to the data independence? See, a view may be thought of as a virtual table. View is a virtual table. That is the table that does not really exist in its own right, but it is instead derived from one or more underlying base tables. In other words, there is no stored file that directly represents the view. There is nothing called view. Instead of view, the definition of view is stored in the data dictionary. Okay. Now you want to see something. You want to see a view. There are various tables involved. So their combined query can give you a view. This is a view. So growth and restructuring of base tables is not reflected in views. Thus, the views can insulate users from the effects of restructuring and growth in the database. And it actually accounts for the logical data independence. So view actually accounts for the logical data independence. What is data model? What do we mean when we say data model? The answer is a collection of conceptual tools for describing data relationships, data semantics and constraints. So again, the data model is what? Data model is a collection of conceptual tools for describing data, data relationships, data semantics and constraints. What is ER model? ER model is entity relationship model. And why it is used, why it is there, it's a very important aspect in our DBMS. So this data model is based on real world that consists of basic objects called the entities and relationship among these objects. The entities are described in a database by a set of attributes. These are, you know, entities E1, E2. Say if it is a book. And this is, author or say library. So book is owned by library, you can say. Okay. Now this can be a relationship owned by, and this book can have attribute. Okay. Book can have attribute like name, and it can have attribute of author. So this kind of model is a ER model. What is an object-oriented model? This model is based on the not the entities and relationship between them, but this model is based on the collection of objects. These are the collection of objects. So an object contains values stored in instance variable within the object. So an object contains value stored in the instance value. An object also contains bodies of that code that operate on that object. These bodies of code, these are called methods. Object has values also. Object have code of that operate on it also, which are called methods. So So object that contains same type of values and the same methods, they are grouped together and we call them as a class. So objects, they are grouped together, we call them as a class. These objects have values, these objects have methods. What is an entity? What is an entity? In a real world, a thing which is describable, which has an independent existence, is termed as an entity. What is an entity type? What do we mean by entity type? It is a collection of entities that have similar attributes. Like we talked about the book. Okay, this is a book. Book is an entity. Then it has name, it has author. So all these book, if we call them books now, so all these books, these are having the same entity type. What is entity set? What do we mean by entity set? It is a collection of all entities of particular entity type in the database. Collection of all entities of a particular entity type in the database is entity set. What is an extension of entity type? Extension of entity type. As we said, entity type is a collection of all entities of particular entity type in the database. So, an extension of entity type is the collection of entities of particular entity type that are grouped together into an entity set. See, and those collection of entities of particular entity type which are grouped together into the entity set is the extension of entity type. What is weak entity set? We make a set. Okay. There are various entities. So entity set may have sufficient attributes to form a primary key. These are entities. They have attributes also. Now these attributes are these attributes may be primary also. That means these attributes are able to identify these entities. So an entity set may not have sufficient attribute to form a primary key. They do not have any attribute which can easily identify the entity. So its primary key comprises of its partial key and the primary key of its parent entity. Then it is called to be the weak entity set. See, the simple explanation would be, if attributes are not enough powerful to identify a particular entity, then we say that it is a weak entity set. So it is dependent on the primary key of its parent entity, right? What is an attribute? Attribute, the property. So attribute, it is a particular property which describes the entity. Like we said, a book can have name, cannot have date. Name and data, attributes of book. What is a relation schema and a relation? Relation schema and a relation. A relation schema, which is denoted by R, A1, A2, AN, is made up of a relation which is named, known as a relation name in R, and the list of attributes AI that it contains. So a relation is defined as a set of tuples. A relation is defined as a set of tuples. Let R be the relationship which contains set of tuples T1 to TN. So each tuple is an ordered list of n values V1 to VN. Consider it to be a table. A table, this is a relation. We have number of columns. These columns are nothing but the These are the attributes. They are nothing but the attributes. And each attribute is a name, age, sex, and address. So one line is known as the tuple. So there are number of tuples. So this is a relationship or relation schema. Then what is the degree of a relation? Degree of a relation. Number of attributes of its relation schema, that is number of the columns, is the degree of relation. What is the relationship? What is the relationship? The association among two or more entities is the relationship. Okay, that is, we said book is owned by, say, author, or you can have one more relationship. Book is owned by library, like this. What is the relationship set? The collection of similar relationship is a relationship set. What is the relationship type? Relationship type defines the set of associations or relationship set among a given set of entity types, like is a, has a. Okay. What is the degree of relationship type? Now the degree is the number of entity type participating in a relationship set is the relationship type degree. What is DDL? Data definition language. A database schema is specified by a set of definitions expressed by a special language called DDL. This is data definition language which defines the database schema. What is VDL, View Definition Language? It specifies user views and their mapping to the conceptual schema. What is SDL, Storage Definition Language? So, SDL, this language is to specify the internal schema. Storage Definition Language. So, this language may specify the mapping between two schemas. What is Data Storage Definition Language? Data Storage Definition Language. The storage structures and the access methods which are used by database systems, they are specified by a set of definition, a special type of DDL which is called as the Data Storage Definition Language, DDL. What is DML, Data Manipulation Language? See, this language DML that enable user to access or manipulate data, they are organized by appropriate data model. The language that enable user to access or manipulate data is organized by appropriate data model. So we have procedural DML, we have non-procedural DML. Procedural DML are also low-level DML. Non-procedural are high-level. So data manipulation language DML enable user to access or manipulate data as organized by appropriate data model. So what are these procedural DML? DML requires a user to specify what data are stored, what data are needed, and how to get those data. What is needed and how to get it. Non-procedural DML or high-level DML requires a user to specify what data are needed without even specifying how to get those data. What is DML compiler? It translates DML statements into a query language, into a low-level instruction that the query evaluation engine can understand. This is DML compiler. What is query evaluation engine? What DML compiler has just produced? DML compiler took what? DML compiler, say you have this DML statement. DML statement. It went to DML compiler. DML compiler produces low level instructions. Okay, DML statements are converted to low level. Now low level these statements or instructions, they go to query evaluation engine. And these query evaluation engine, these are the low level instructions which are executed by query evaluation engine. What is DDL interpreter? It interprets the DDL statements and record them in tables containing the metadata. What is record at a time? Record the low level or procedural DML can specify and retrieve each record from set of records. So this retrieval of a data is said to be record at a time. What is set a time or set oriented? The high level or non-procedural DML can specify and retrieve many records in a single DML statement. So this retrieval of a record is said to be a set a time or set oriented. So the high level or non-procedural DML can specify and retrieve many records in a single DML statement. This is set at a time or set oriented. What is relational algebra? It is a procedural query language. Relational algebra is a procedural query language. Actually, the RDBMS, it follows the relational algebra only. So it consists of set of operations that take one or two relations as input and it produces a new relation. So what is a relational calculus? What is a relational calculus? It is an applied predicate calculus, relational calculus, specially or specifically tailored for relational database purpose by EF Codd. So relational calculus coming from relational algebra, and this is an applied predicate calculus of relation calculus which is tailored by specifically for the database by EF Codd, which is based on DSL Alpha and QL, the languages which are based on DSL Alpha and QL. How does tuple-oriented relational calculus differ from domain-oriented relational calculus? Tuple-oriented and domain-oriented. The tuple-oriented calculus uses a tuple variables. That is variables whose only permitted values are tuple of that relation. That is, for example, QEVEL. These were the languages. The domain-oriented calculus has domain variables, not the tuple variables. So, variables that range over the underlying domains instead of over a relation. These are ILL and deduce. These are the domain-oriented relational calculus. So these are few questions on RDBMS concepts. So we'll be taking more of these shortly. Thank you so much. Take care.